Worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and divinity and wisdom and strength and honor. Alleluia. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. As we come with great joy to the altar of Christ to receive from him the grace of salvation, let us now acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we who have come to know the grace of the Lord's resurrection may, through the love of the Spirit, ourselves rise to newness of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Saul, still breathing murderous threats against the disciples of the Lord, went to the high priest and asked him for letters to the synagogues in Damascus, that if he should find any men or women who belonged to the way, he might bring them back to Jerusalem in chains. On his journey, as he was nearing Damascus, a light from the sky suddenly flashed around him. He fell to the ground and heard a voice saying to him, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" He said, "Who are you, sir?" The reply came, "I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting. Now get up and go into the city, and you will be told what you must do." The men who were traveling with him stood speechless, for they heard the voice but could see no one. Saul got up from the ground, but when he opened his eyes, he could see nothing. So they led him by the hand and brought him to Damascus. For 3 days he was unable to see, and he neither ate nor drank. There was a disciple in Damascus named Ananias. And the Lord said to him in a vision, "Ananias." He answered, "Here I am, Lord." The Lord said to him, "Get up and go to the street called Straight, and ask at the house of Judas for a man from Tarsus named Saul. He is there praying, and in a vision he has seen a man named Ananias come in and lay his hands on him, that he may regain his sight." But Ananias replied, "Lord, I have heard from many sources about this man, what evil things he has done to your holy ones in Jerusalem. And here he has authority from the chief priests to imprison all who call upon your name." But the Lord said to him, "Go, for this man is a chosen instrument of mine to carry my name before Gentiles, kings, and children of Israel." So Ananias went and entered the house. Laying his hands on him, he said, "Saul, my brother, the Lord has sent me. Jesus, who appeared to you on the way by which you came, that you may regain your sight and be filled with the Holy Spirit." Immediately, things like scales fell from his eyes, and he regained his sight. He got up and was baptized, and when he had eaten, he recovered his strength. He stayed some days with the disciples in Damascus, and he began at once to proclaim Jesus in the synagogues, that he is the Son of God. The word of the Lord. Go out to all the world and tell the good news. Go out to all the world and tell the good news. Praise the Lord, all you nations. Glorify him, all you peoples. Go out to all the world and tell the good news. For steadfast is his kindness toward us, and the fidelity of the Lord endures forever. Go out to all the world and tell the good news. Alleluia, alleluia. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me and I in him, says the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, "How can this man give us his flesh to eat?" Jesus said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever." These things he said while teaching in the synagogue in Capernaum. The Gospel of the Lord. I was in the, I think it was the third grade classroom the other day at our regional school. And in the course of the conversation, the topic of Jesus giving us his flesh to eat and his blood to drink came on. It's remarkable, I found, how with an unprejudiced mind, even a third grader can begin to understand the deep mysteries of God. Sometimes it happens that as one gets older and one's mind develops and is exposed to lots of different types of thinking, that clarity of vision into the mysteries of God gets clouded. Thus, the importance is, all of you who are parents who have raised children in the faith, you know how essential it is to promote that youthful faithfulness and to nourish it so that when contrary opinions, philosophies of human origin are presented to them, they are able to cling to the mysteries of faith. So I said to the third graders, "Well, you know, we're not talking about gnawing on somebody's flesh as if we were cannibals. That's not the kind of eating that is happening in the Eucharist. But it isn't bread and wine that we are eating. It is the sacrament of Jesus' body and blood. It is his body and blood, though we eat it sacramentally. That's a different way of eating flesh and drinking blood that, let's say, a cannibal would do. But it truly is feeding on the humanity of Jesus that is united to his divinity, on his person. And that when we do this in faith and love for Jesus, then that faith and love increases within us. And I think they got it, but I'll repeat it many times to them. We've heard the statistic that 70% of Catholics, those who identify as Catholics, believe that the Eucharist is just a symbol of Jesus, but not our risen Lord himself. I scratch my head at that because I don't think I've met anyone in our parish who believes that. At least they've never admitted that to me. I think we all understand that this is the Lord. That's what draws us here. We wouldn't get up in the morning and come to church just to look at a symbol. We want the Lord, and he wants to give himself to us. But the eating of the flesh of the Son of Man and drinking his blood is not simply a matter of my personal encounter with Jesus. It's the encounter of the church with Jesus. It's all of us together. And in drawing close to Jesus and being strengthened in faith and love for him, we are also strengthened in our love for one another and for living the Christian life, which is a life in the church and for the church. And in our kind of individualistic approach to so many things in our contemporary culture, we might think, well, it really is just about me and Jesus, and my brothers and sisters who are with me at Mass are, you know, just there by happenstance. What really matters is me and Jesus. But the Lord never looked at things that way. When the young man asked him, Lord, what is the greatest of all the commandments? He said, of course, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength. But then he added, and you shall love your neighbor as yourself, implying that this was actually kind of two parts of the one commandment. That one could not fulfill the first part without the second. Absolutely. So the Christian life is life in the church, life in the community, life with one another, as we bear with one another, because we're sinners. That's why we come to Jesus, so that we can become holy, freed from sin, and as we assist each other along the ways of faith. For St. Luke, who was a companion of Paul, his dramatic encounter with Jesus that led to his faith in Jesus was so important. It's mentioned three times in the Acts of the Apostles, three different accounts. Why is that so significant? Well, certainly because Luke knew Paul, and he accompanied Paul in his missionary journeys, and who in the early church could even hold a candle to the type of generous service of Paul in going from place to place to place to make Jesus known? The other apostles certainly did, but Paul, amazing. But Luke wanted to make it very clear that it is encounter with Jesus that is the beginning of faith. And it is a continual encounter with Jesus in the life of the church and in the sacraments by which faith grows. And faith, of course, is the conduit for receiving the love of the Holy Spirit. The love which is the Holy Spirit, as we prayed in our opening prayer today. And so I'd like for a minute just to look at the figure of Ananias in this story. Because when the Lord, as it says, spoke to him in a vision, which is another way of saying that Ananias was a man of faith, and he could recognize the Lord's voice when he spoke to him, as we are meant to. When the Lord said, Ananias, his answer was, here I am, Lord. Remember the passage of the prophet Samuel when he was very young. He was in the house of Eli the priest of Shiloh. And the Lord called him, and Samuel thought that it was Eli calling him. And then Eli, who was a man of faith and open to the ways of the Lord, knowledgeable about them, said, no, no, no. He knew this was the Lord. So Samuel, when you hear that voice again, say, here I am, Lord, your servant is listening. And this is exactly what Ananias says. And therefore, it should be exactly what we say every morning. Here I am, Lord. Show me what you want me to do and give me the grace to do it. Let us stand. What father would give his children stones when they ask for bread? How much more then does our Heavenly Father give us good things when we ask him in faith and in devotion? Lord, you led your people through the sea dry shod in the days of Moses. Let us put our trust in you as you lead us through this day's challenges. We pray to the Lord. Grant our prayer, O Lord. Lord, you fed your people in the desert for 40 years before they entered the promised land. Let us hear your word of life amid the noise of our busy lives today as we journey towards our heavenly kingdom. We pray to the Lord. Grant our prayer, O Lord. Lord, in their thirst, you gave them water from a rock. Let us drink from the fountain of life that is found in the sacraments of your church. We pray to the Lord. Grant our prayer, O Lord, for peace in the world and the protection of our servicemen and women and first responders, for those who have fallen, for the consolation of their families. We pray to the Lord. Grant our prayer, O Lord, for God's blessings of unity and peace upon all marriages and families, for an abundance of vocations to the priesthood, diaconate, and consecrated life. We pray to the Lord. Grant our prayer, O Lord, for God's blessings of unity and for God's blessings upon our parish and all of our parish apostolates, that we may be unified in that one faith that is nourished and strengthened by our participation in the Eucharist, so that we may bear fruit for the new evangelization. We pray to the Lord. Grant our prayer, O Lord, for all those who are burdened by any need, for the sick and dying, the homeless and unemployed, for widows and orphans, refugees, immigrants and migrants, for victims of war, violence, natural disasters, persecutions, and human exploitation. For all the suffering poor, we pray to the Lord. Grant our prayer, O Lord, for all those who have died in the hope of resurrection, especially among our family, friends, benefactors, and fellow parishioners, we pray to the Lord. Grant our prayer, O Lord, and for those special prayers which we bring before the Lord this day. O Lord our God, you sent into the midst of a fallen race the living bread, your risen Son, our Lord Jesus, to nourish and strengthen us on the road that leads to eternal life. Through the mystery of his cross, you poured forth upon us the Holy Spirit, the water of life. Have mercy on our lack of trust and lead us in your ways today through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord. Amen. And this Mass is being offered for the intentions of Anna Marie Garcia. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You therefore, Almighty Father, we bless through Jesus Christ, your Son, who comes in your name. He himself is the word that brings salvation, the hand you extend to sinners, the way by which your peace is offered to us. When we ourselves had turned away from you on account of our sins, you brought us back to be reconciled, O Lord, so that converted at last to you, we might love one another through your Son, whom for our sake you handed over to death. And now, celebrating the reconciliation Christ has brought us, we entreat you, sanctify these gifts by the outpouring of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, whose command we fulfill when we celebrate these mysteries. For when about to give his life to set us free, as he reclined at supper, he himself took bread into his hands, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, on that same evening, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, confessing your mercy, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Celebrating, therefore, the memorial of the death and resurrection of your Son, who left us this pledge of his love, we offer you what you have bestowed on us, the sacrifice of perfect reconciliation. Holy Father, we humbly beseech you to accept us also together with your Son, and in this saving banquet, graciously to endow us with his very Spirit, who takes away everything that estranges us from one another. May he make your church a sign of unity and an instrument of your peace among all people, and may he keep us in communion with Francis, our Pope, and Wilton, our Bishop, and all the bishops, and your entire people. Just as you have gathered us now at the table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles, with Saint Hugh and all the saints, and with our brothers and sisters and those of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship. Bring us to share with them the unending banquet of unity in a new heaven and a new earth, where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Christ Jesus our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And may the peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The crucified is risen from the dead and has redeemed us. Alleluia. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth and charity. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Thanks be to God. Regina Caeli, letare, alleluia. Quia quem meruisti portare, alleluia. Resurrexit, sicut dixit, alleluia. Ora pro nobis Deum, alleluia. Saint Joseph, pray for us.